Welcome! Today we'll be talking about how to add a calendar in Excel. Thanks to this function, you'll be able to use a date picker, which allows you to comfortably enter dates in data tables. Shall we start? Hello, and welcome to EasyClick Academy. My name's Maria, and together with our EasyClick team, we're here to make sure you'll be able to use Excel in a quick and easy way, thanks to our digestible video tutorials. There's more than one way to add a calendar or date picker in Excel, and, as usual, we'll have a closer look at the quickest and simplest one. To install a calendar in Excel, we need to activate the Developer tab first. So, let's click on File up here and select Options. Once this window appears, click on Customize Ribbon. Look on the right-hand side of the pane and select Developer to activate it. Now just click on OK, and that's done. You'll see the Developer tab up here among the rest of the tabs. We can move on now and install the calendar in Excel, which is a very easy thing to do. Open the Developer tab and click on Add-ins. Here we can add various useful elements to the Excel application. Since we want a calendar, we open the Office Store and type Calendar in the search field. After we press Enter, we'll see this mini calendar and date picker available in the first place. We click on Add, and now we can work with it and use it in spreadsheets. Of course, we can place the calendar just where we need. Click on any of its borders with the left mouse button, hold it, and move the calendar wherever you want. You can also change its size using these little circles in the corners. More amendments can be made through settings. For example, you can show the week number or change the calendar system. You can also adjust the style of the calendar, its color, for instance. But that's not all. Let's have a look at how to enter specific dates to data tables thanks to the calendar function. Let's say we want to enter the start date for task 1. Click on the cell C3. That's where we want to have the date displayed. Then look the date up in the date picker. For example, task 1 is supposed to start on the 1st of August. And here we go. The date's in the cell C3 just as we wanted. We can use the same way to enter dates for the rest of the tasks. We click on the cell, pick the date, and that's it. And before we wrap it up, here's a handy trick. If you don't need to use the date picker anymore, just click on any of the borders and press the delete key. And it'll be gone in a split second. To have it back on screen again, just click on the Developer tab. Go to Add-ins, just as you did before, and now you'll see it among the already used add-ins. Click on it again, and you'll see it back in no time. If you found this tutorial helpful, give us a like and watch other video tutorials by EasyClick Academy. Learn how to use Excel in a quick and easy way. Is this your first time on EasyClick? We'll be more than happy to welcome you in our online community. Hit that subscribe button and join the EasyClickers. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.